So usually for the AI in school, AI is the undergraduate, yeah, undergraduate of the every computer science or informatics. So if Google still only recruit the non scientists or non academics, they only recruit the people have the ability to programming and etc. Nah, I think this is not good good choice, yeah, because the Microsoft and also another still recruit the PhD, because AI only discuss and studied in the academics. We can create the programming with just some short course and etc. But for the science, we have to focus and maybe need a lot of effort, yeah, to study new technology. For example, there is a GPT-3 and maybe there is another GPT-4 and etc. So we only don't just use the method, but we have to create. And also for the master degree, you must have the ability to analyze what methods that appropriate for your system, yeah, of your proposed system, yeah. So different with undergraduate, for master you have to decide, yeah, some analytic thinking about the what the method that must be I choose, you know, to for appropriate method, you know. Neural network, fuzzy, or another machine learning, previous machine learning, you have to decide, you know. For example, we continue to neural network, you know, we can add for training, for example, how to analyze, how to use simple network in Python, yeah, or neural network. You should have the data first, because data mining, machine learning, deep learning, or something that need a learning, it relate to data. And then you shoot the architecture, a lot of architecture, and then you need the train database, train data set, sorry. And then you have to have the ability to evaluate mean that we check or test the network using the another data and it still give the appropriate result or not, compare to the result before or the real result. This is using the available Keras network, ya, yeah. And then we use the layers. Where is the dataset? Okay, what is can you simple one neuron network. Use the perceptron. This is object oriented style, yeah. object oriented must be have the class, and inside the class must be there is a attribute. This is the attribute. Attribute, and then there is also the function or method or operation. This is the in Python the function or the method is in def, yeah. And then you have to indent this, do not the same column, yeah. And then there is a two, actually there is a one, yeah, one method here, because this is usually called the constructor, yeah. This is the initial, yeah. Input save, and then push, we create the empty set, empty zero, yeah, zero, and then we predict. This is called the perceptron. This is the first neural network. And you test the network for n operation, for example. This is actually the this is the input, and then this is the expected output, yeah, for n is only the same one and one and one. If there is a no, there is a zero, must be zero, yeah. This is the system output. Okay, we just check this code with our Jupyter notebook. I hope you have installed the Jupyter notebook or Python, yeah. This is the NumPy. NumPy is a powerful library for matrix manipulation, yeah. This is the famous library, because previous programming language, for example C++, what else, difficult to create the matrix. And then MATLAB come with the ability to manipulate the matrix, yeah. So MATLAB is stands for matrix laboratory, MATLAB, yeah. So this is the weight. Actually this is not machine learning, yeah, because the weight has been defined, yeah. This is the old neuron in 19, where is McCullough, yeah? This is the Warren McCullough and Walter Pitt. This is the first using this kind of structure, yeah. They only use this weight and the bias. This is for calculation, this is for translation or addition or subtraction. And then we check the input here, and then test the output. We don't need the neural network toolkit, yeah, because only just mathematical calculation here. We only import the array, yeah, or matrix, yeah. And then we calculate by the formula, yeah. You see there is a, where is the formula here, yeah. This is the, yeah, the formula. This is for just the formula ya, calculation of input with the weights. This is the weight, the input and weight, and also bias. But I think we don't see any bias here, yeah. So bias is, where is the introduction of bias? Oh, maybe there is here. This is a bias, yeah. Bias is come later. This is the bias. Because bias is useful when you want to make some, for example, this is the here, the angle of this is the weight, and for bias this is only for, this is the bias, yeah, the bias. And for the weight is here, this is weight, yeah. So we need to bias to, for example, this is the class, and then this is the class B. So we need, sometimes need a bias set to make the best line, separated line, ya, here. Maybe we can separate line here, or maybe we will see in the support vector machine, ya, for better the line separator here. Okay, we see the Jupyter notebook. See the, of course, neural networks usually have the output do not exactly the same with the input, ya, yeah. Actually this must be zero, and this is must be zero, and this is should be one, because and truth table is the, if one and one, it should be one, or we can change for or, yeah. Or is, this is one. Okay, we run again, we see this is okay, true, but there is a problem here. Okay, usually for classification we have to create the output, the exact class, yeah, exact class. So it must be the output is the zero. We use the run the output, yeah. Okay, we can ask the how to run the output. Usually ini the output, but I forget to the syntax of the here, ya, yeah, and numpy run the outputnya, yeah. So string, where is the output? Oh, I have to add. In order we get the exact rounding, yeah, because for regression maybe it's okay we use this, but for the classification we need to match the exact class, yeah. Okay, you see this is the accuracy is 100%, yeah, if we compare. Sorry, oh, there is a problem here. The output is run round is zero. Oh, there is a problem here, yeah, because this is only for, so we have to arrange again this weights. Or bobot ya, weights for or so you can use bias minus 0.1 and then 1 and 1 0.5. This is actually the scientist in 1940 ya, create the neural network using calculator ya, calculator to calculate this without computer programming, and then the this is 1 ya, 1 and 1. Let's we try again. And we check the output. Okay, you see this is the exact result, yeah. So you have successfully create the OR, but there is a problem here when we create the XOR, exclusive OR, ya. Can we create the XOR from above code? Yes, we cannot create exclusive OR using a single neural network, single neuron. XOR as XOR is not linearly separable problem. I don't know, this is from go to the multilayer perception ya, Rosenblatt ya, there is a 10. Okay, we continue. Sorry, it is a call. Linear is variable because exclusive OR is where is the this is for example 1 and 1. Exclusive OR is if there is no same ya, yeah, the same input and output of 0 and 1, this is the 1 and 0 and 1, but for 0 and 0 it must be 0, and for the 1 and 1 it must be a class 0 ya, yeah. So we have to create to, of course, we cannot create one single line to separate this. For example, this is star, and this is moon, for example, ya, yeah, or moon. So we don't have, we need two lines, ya. Yeah. Or this is the first line, and this is the second line. So we can use two separate line, ya. Yeah. You can try one line to separate this star and moon, ya, yeah. It is this impossible with straight line or not or linear, ya, linear line. Of course, we can create the here, like line here, of course, but usually the neural network is using the linear line, ya. Do not this can use this non-linear. So we have to need two linear line here, two layer. So we to solve now we go to the multi-layer perceptron. Can you give code for SOR? To solve, ya, solve with neural net. Nah, this is, this is using the Keras, ya. I don't want to use the state of the art, ya, but we can. Can we use two neuron? This is the neuron for the SOR problem here. This is the we use the learning I mean without learning, ya, just weight composition. It's not linear to solve a non-linear activation function and train. Non-linear we just create two separated line here. With minimum neuron. Single layer perceptron. It's not linearly separable, ya. So we have to use this learning, ya. So okay, we just try here. It is a sigmoid function, yeah. And then this is the input output. We create this composition. There is two neuron input because there is two input, yeah. So two, and then we have one output. And then we have two hidden neuron. Yeah, you see that the testing. Where is the testing? Oh, this is the for checking. Yeah, this is, so you see the after rounding. Okay. Yeah. I want to print. This is the exact, the without rounding. This is but instead of using this for evaluation accuracy, usually we use this. Even this is the 100% accurate, but usually there is an error here. This is actually not one but 0.9 something. So This is usually useful for checking the accuracy, the real accuracy, but for the matrix confusion, this is okay for checking the true false, negative false, etc. Can we draw the plot or plot the network of the code above? Yeah. Using we use the this is the GraphFish This is a library to create the graph. So for easy, you can just copy paste and how to show the graph of the network from code here. It's a netbox library. It's just the this library usually is open source because this was generated by some scientists around the world. This is maybe if you want to understand this library, you can just follow the official site of this library. You can go to the Python and then you go to this site. This is a software, and then if you want to learn, you have to read the documentation here. There is a version and then highlight. You can also, where is it? This is a guide, I think. Yeah. Gallery example, and this is, oh, this is it. Yeah. Okay, we try to see the result. We add some cell again and then just copy paste. Actually, this is the additional for the here, and then there is some addition, for example, in this library. Okay, we check. You know that this is the typical error for the if you don't understand the problem. Usually there is an answer for this problem. You have to install networks. You just follow the suggestion, and this will be installing maybe 5 megabytes or more. And starting the connected. Okay. Okay, we just run again. If still there is error here. Actually, the AI is an interesting topics. Oh, only here the network. It is input. Where is this? Oh. Input, and then there is two input. There is one. Oh, this is not good presentation, I think. Input, input two. There is two input. Yeah, input one, input two. One input two. There is a hidden one, hidden two. I think the network is like this. Yeah. Input one, input two. There is two neuron in hidden network. There is two neuron in hidden network. For example, in H1 and H2. One here, input two to hidden one and hidden two, one and hidden two, and this is the output. The output, output is the hidden two, hidden one. So this is the network. The network of this composition. Yeah. And then usually we need the this is the weight, yeah, this is the weight, and we don't have the bias. Actually this is, there is a bias here, yeah, bias, but in this structure we don't see the bias, yeah. Okay, for example, I want to bias, can you give the code above bias, biases, biases? This is the same active, oh, activation function, yeah. And then we have a bias. Bias is in hidden neuron, yeah, and also in input. Oh, sorry, this is also, there is a bias, yeah. Bias in hidden and in output. Yeah. Okay, we just checking again. Oh, I think we need the with the network X also with because we need the structure, yeah. So I want to see this structure with bias. So you see, this is the learning method here. Learn this learning rate using the gradient descent. In this book, yeah, you can see the gradient descent. Is the gradient in the capture 331 gradient descent. This is the calculation for more than one layer. So okay, we check again with the bias. We can add new cell, and then we have already add the bias here, and then we create the this is the bias, this is a hidden layer, the mathematical calculation is here, this is the weight one and bias two, bias one. This is the calculation for backpropagation here. You see why we use the where the link. X1, X2, D1, and where is the bias? Yeah? I don't see the bias in network. Include bias here is an upload. Ah, yeah. We need the updating again here. This is the error calculation comparing prediction with the actual result. Okay, we check again. Just add. Student only need the right question for everything. So sometimes it is difficult to create question instead of answering the question. So in 2030 I come to Thailand and I have to ask a question to everyone, where is the location of something, how to make the propose the dissertation, and the question is important. If you have, oh, there is a problem here, yeah. So you can try adding. Here is location. Yeah, so comment being in a separated cell. You can try adding. Well, you draw an X draw. An X draw. Where is an X draw? PLT so. Set here. If so, there is asterisk here is still in running, or you see this, there is a sun clock here. I think there is a problem. Okay, we will fix later. Yeah, how to draw this. But the most important is you can understand the here. Yeah, you see there is a differentiation. Yeah, difference. Why we use the difficult equation here? This is exponential, ya. You can ask why we use sigmoid for the network. Yeah, yeah. Because if you make a differentiation for the back propagation, it's easy, because you see the sigmoid differentiation is only here, yeah. It is the simple simple differentiation, yeah. Okay. So it's easy. We can just see here, yeah. You see here. And we have introduced the epoch. Epoch is the we forward, and then we compare prediction, and then we go back to. So we call back propagation, yeah, backward, and backward we use this calculation, you know, yeah, or back propagation, yeah. Of course we need a learning rate. Learning rate is how far the, for example, we need the some delta, yeah. Delta here, delta. So more higher learning rate, more faster, but maybe you see that if we compare this tangga itu, ya. So this is more accurate. This is, but this is more farther, because this is we calculate one by one. This is only 1, 2, 3. It just depend on your problem or computer hardware. So this is my first code. Yeah. So we continue to another problem. Batch learning. This is the cross validation. Yeah. Cross validation is the where is the cross validation explanation? Yeah. For example, we have. Data, yeah. X1, X2, and this is some record. So usually we have 80% for train, and then the last 20% for test. This is usually, yeah, we. If we use the split function in scikit-learn, usually we use this. But of course, if the training is not good, I think the good is do not complete, do not all class is separate equally. So it means that the train data is bad. So the result is also bad, yeah, because the training dataset is not good. Yeah. To overcome this problem, there is a cross validation. This is, for example, there is a One group 20, so this is there is four group, 2, 3, 4. There is a, for example, this is 100 data set. This is 20 data set, 20 data set. And this for the testing is 20 and 20 for test. So okay, on we for this data set is only 40, and we create this 40 and this 40. So we have three group, yeah? The first group and second group become the training data set, and the remaining 40 data set become testing. And we have the second training. For example, this is A, this is B, and this is C. We C and A become C training data, and the B become test data. Test, and then we go to the third train. The where is this? The C. A become test data set, and then B and C become training data set. This is the cross validation, yeah. And because we have three group, so we called it threefold cross validation, yeah. This is the because this is more fair, every group become training, also testing, yeah, and testing. So the cross validation is more. You can ask the chat what is cross validation. Usually for a small data set, yeah, because we have to make a fair separation for training and testing. You see the k-fold validation in this example, we use 3. The standard number of K, what is the standard K? Usually is 10, yeah. So the standard for K cross validation, we separate 10 group. So usually 9 for training and 1 group for testing, and rotate until every group become test data and train data. How to okay. I mean, misalnya ada 5 cross validasi, 2, 3, 4, 5. Ini akurasinya, berarti ya di rata-rata ternyata, ya. Misalnya Di sini akurasinya 70%. 0,7 yang di sini 0,6. Kenapa 0,6? Misalnya karena data trainingnya jelek gitu kan, atau data testingnya yang jelek gitu kan. Di sini 0,9, wah akurat banget misalnya. Berarti nanti rata-ratanya ya 0,7, 0,6, 0,9 ya. Nanti 0,7 berapa ini? 72 atau 71 gitu ya. Jadi dia di rata-rata ternyata ini. Oke, terus kita maju terus sampai se cukupnya gitu ya. Mana ini? Ada radial basis, terus ini udah saya bookmarknya sudah saya perceptron tadi udah ya. Praktek pakai Python, kemudian ini activation function juga. Sigmoid ada lagi, tanya aja. This is the sigmoid, ada ReLU, rectified linear unit, tangan hiperbolik, and softmax ya. Rectified return unit is non linear, biasa dipakai di deep learning, tapi ini kelemahannya dia kan bisa membesar terus ya, jadi ini membesar terus ya, jadi dia beda dibanding dengan sigmoid yang seperti ini gitu kan, dia maksimum 1, dia ini bisa infinity. Tapi sebelum masuk ke ReLU biasanya di normalize ya, normalize itu membuat angka ya maksimum 1 ya. Jadi sebenarnya ini ya menjaga seperti ini pada ReLU.